Hey guys, so today I'm just making this video to show you how you can basically change your kernel on your Galaxy Ace. Now I'm showing you how to install V84CF root kernel, and you can basically do it with your other kernels that you have. But this kernel is fixed by me and someone else because it got some problems. I fixed it myself, and you know, let's get into it. First of all, you have to copy the file that I set the link in the description with these cables, basically, you know, these cables, the stock Galaxy cables, you know, or any other micro USB cable. You can do it, and you have to copy all your files, and then after copying it over your phone, you need to have clockwork mod recovery. I will make a video for that later on when I'm because I'm planning to make a restock video for your Galaxy Ace, and then I will show you how to install clockwork mod recovery, touch based. Yeah, I have the touch clockwork mod recovery. So as you can see, this is my Galaxy Ace running on SGS2 ROM, and I got some problems with its kernel because its battery extender, and it doesn't have the support for swap partition, because I got so many apps running in the background at the same time. I need my swap partition, so I will make a video later on for that if you want. First of all, you have to go to your recovery mode. I'm doing it manually to show you how to do it, make you sure. And this ROM is really great ROM, you should try it out. I got a video already on it, you go ahead and watch it in my channel. I will, you know, you can touch anywhere on the screen, I will put the links, you can touch and go to that video. Just wait for it to then you have to take the home button and the power, first of all, home button, hold it down, and the power button. Yeah, then release the home power button and still get the home button when you till you reach here. This is basically the clockwork mod recovery. This is not touch based recovery, and so I forgot to mention that, because this kernel comes with this recovery. If you want a flash touch recovery, I will make the links in description. No, I will make another video and I will let the links then in the description of this video. Just wait for focus. Yeah, now you have to go to install zip from SD card. No, press the home button here and wait, choose it from a stick card, press the home button, go down, 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 down. I put it in this folder, kernel, basically, and let's focus. Oh, stuck. You know, you have to print this file. This B82 got some problems. I made the fixed version myself, you can go and try it out. Fixed by Android, install it. Yeah, as you can see, it's installing right now. You know, fixed by Android and Sandroid. This is a great kernel, you should try it out. It's basically doesn't have any lag, you can overclock your phone, then reboot your system, just Just reboot your system. Wait for it to boot up. And also, no, not yet. I forgot what to say. Samsung. Great Samsung. I love Samsung. And it's booting up right now. And you, when it boots up, I show you what to do for your root access. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I should tell you that, you know, my channel got some stuff for Galaxy Ace, Galaxy S3, some news, Galaxy Tab GTP 1000, or, you know, I got some stuff for Galaxy SL, Galaxy Nexus. If you got a request for, you know, ROM or anything, you can ask me, I will do it for you. I got Jelly Bean for CM10, Jelly Bean CM10 review for Galaxy Tab. I got so many videos. You should, so you can subscribe me if you want. We'll make videos. And for this video, the previous video, so many people complained for my sound. And you know, basically what the sound is that the microphone is down here, and this, as you can hear, it got so much noise, and it's because of this. You know, I have to try to, you know, fix it. Next time I won't use it. So so let's see if it's boot up. Yeah, it's, I think, let's see, media scan finish. Oh, still 3 pages of apps. Still not loaded. That's something I don't like about Galaxy Ace, that it doesn't have that much, you know, space for the internal storage. You know, it's a mid-range phone, it doesn't need that. You know, you have to do all this stuff yourself. And I will show you how to make, I want to make some videos more about how to, you know, install, make partitions or for your SD card or something like that. I will make it later on when you wanna, you know, when I got time. Actually, this is exam times for me and I can't do that. So let's see, all my apps are back. So now let's see. Wait, I have to enable my swap storage. If not, my phone will be slow as shit because it's, I got so many applications that always want to run in background. So wait. You have to download and so sorry for the pause I made. Yeah, I got a Skype call. You have to download the latest super user app. I know that most of you have it, or you know, but if you don't have, you have to upgrade it to latest version. As you can see, I have the latest version installed. Then it's right now, it's 3.1.3. you need to have it if you want great root access. And then you have to, you know, simply swipe over here and in the info tab and SU binary, tap on that. It will show something like this. Basically, I'm trying to, you know, update it in the kernel itself, but I have to do it later on because I don't have enough time, as I said. and you have to press the update. Yeah, it will basically download every SU binary file that is needed for root access. Now it has a root access, because, but if you want the latest root access, which is I think needed, and most of the apps need that, you have to update it every single, you know, time that it needs an update. You have to check it, for example, even if you want, or let's wait. Oh, sorry for the notification I had. And you have to come out of the app, you know, close down the app, and then run it again and see whether you have the 3.1.1 or not. Yeah, I have it right now. So that's my video to how to install a kernel for your Galaxy Ace. Hope you enjoyed it. I will let the kernel link in the description so you can download it or do whatever you want with it. I'm not sure what you want to do if you don't want to download, but you can install every other kernel that you want. This way, this is the easiest way. Oh, let me make you sure that this is B84 kernel. So you have to come to Tweaks Manager and see this is B84. This 84 means that this is B84 kernel. So yeah, just have an awesome day. Bye bye.